वेलकम टू साइटेक AI यूटोपिया। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट हाउ सिमुलेशंस आर डन यूजिंग ए सुपर कंप्यूटर। ए कंप्यूटर सिमुलेशन इज बेसिकली ए कंप्यूटेशनल मॉडल दैट मिमिक्स द बिहेवियर ऑफ ए रियल वर्ल्ड सिस्टम टू एनालाइज, अंडरस्टैंड और प्रेडिक्ट इट्स डायनामिक्स। इट इन्वॉल्व्स यूजिंग मैथमेटिकल एल्गोरिथम्स एंड न्यूमेरिकल मेथड्स टू सिमुलेट द इंटरैक्शंस एंड प्रोसेसेस विद इन ए गिवन सिस्टम। To better understand computer simulation, imagine you are planning a road trip to a new city. Before embarking on the journey, you pull out a map and use it to visualize the route, estimate travel time, and anticipate potential challenges like traffic or detours. In this context, the map serves as a simplified simulation of your upcoming travel experience. Now extend this idea to a computer simulation. But instead of a road trip, you are exploring complex scenarios like predicting weather patterns, understanding the behavior of a new material in a laboratory, or studying the dynamics of a biological system. A computer simulation is like a digital map, but for a much more intricate system. It represents a real-world situation using mathematical equations and models. Just as a map simplifies the geography of a city, a simulation simplifies and abstracts the details of a complex system, capturing its essential features. Much like looking at the map before your trip, a computer simulation allows you to see what might happen in a given scenario without physically experiencing it. You can run the simulation to experiment with different conditions, make predictions, and observe outcomes virtually, saving time and resources compared to conducting experiments in the real world. Through simulation, you gain insights into how the system behaves under various conditions. It helps you understand the cause and effect relationships within the simulated environment. Just as your map helps you predict the best route and possible challenges, a computer simulation aids in predicting outcomes and understanding the consequences of different factors on the system. It is like a virtual playground where you can test ideas, strategies, or changes to the system without tangible consequences. You can iterate through different possibilities, refining the model or strategy until you find the most effective or desirable outcome. A computer simulation lets you optimize and improve the system by tweaking variables or parameters. In essence, a computer simulation is a powerful tool that creates a digital realm for exploring, understanding, and predicting the behavior of complex systems. It is like having a dynamic, interactive map for the intricate landscapes of science, engineering, and various other fields, allowing you to navigate through possibilities, make informed decisions, and gain valuable insights. Even the Earth can be simulated by modeling the atmosphere, oceans, and land surfaces, biological interactions, human activities, numerical methods, and supercomputer implementations. Earth simulation provides a virtual laboratory for studying the intricate and interconnected processes shaping the planet's climate. So, this was a brief info and example on computer simulation. Now, let us look at how simulations are done using supercomputers, which involve solving complex mathematical models to study and analyze various phenomena ranging from climate patterns to molecular interactions. Firstly, we need to define the problem. Consider a scenario where scientists aim to simulate the air flow around an advanced aircraft wing to optimize its aerodynamic performance. The problem is to understand how air flows over and around the wing, considering factors such as air speed, wing shape, and environmental conditions. Next, we need to do modeling. Mathematical model could involve Navier-Stokes equations, which describe the motion of fluid or air in this case. These partial differential equations, or PDEs, account for factors like viscosity, pressure, and velocity. Next, we need to do discretization, which comes in various varieties. First is spatial discretization, which means dividing the physical space around the aircraft wing into a mesh of small elements. Each element represents a portion of the air space, allowing the simulation to focus on specific regions. For instance, the surface of the wing might have a finer mesh to capture detailed aerodynamic effects. सेकेंड वन इज टेम्पोरल डिस्क्रिटाइजेशन, विच मीन्स ब्रेकिंग डाउन टाइम इंटू डिस्क्रीट स्टेप्स. लेट अस से द सिमुलेशन एम्स टू एनालाइज द एयर फ्लो ओवर सेवरल सेकेंड्स ऑफ फ्लाइट. द टाइम स्टेप कुड बी फ्रैक्शंस ऑफ ए सेकेंड, इनेबलिंग द सिमुलेशन टू कैप्चर चेंजेस इन द एयर फ्लो डायनामिक्स ओवर स्मॉल इंटरवल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इमेजिन ए 3D ग्रिड रिप्रेजेंटिंग द एयर स्पेस अराउंड द विंग. ईच सेल इन द ग्रिड कंटेन्स इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट एयर प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक वेलोसिटी, प्रेशर एट ए स्पेसिफिक पॉइंट. द स्मॉलर द सेल्स द मोर डिटेल्ड द सिमुलेशन, बट एट द कॉस्ट ऑफ इंक्रीज्ड कंप्यूटेशनल रिक्वायरमेंट्स. सिमिलरली इन द टाइम डोमेन, इफ द सिमुलेशन इज ओवर 10 सेकेंड्स एंड द टाइम स्टेप इज 0.001 सेकेंड्स, देयर वुड बी 10,000 टाइम स्टेप्स. इन एसेंस, दिस डिस्क्रिटाइजेशन अलोस द सिमुलेशन टू अप्रॉक्सीमेट द कंटिन्यूअस इक्वेशंस इन ए मैनेजेबल वे, ब्रेकिंग डाउन द कॉम्प्लेक्स मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम इंटू स्मॉलर सॉल्वेबल कंपोनेंट्स. दिस लेस द फाउंडेशन फॉर द सब्सिक्वेंट न्यूमेरिकल मेथड्स एंड एल्गोरिथम्स यूज्ड इन द सिमुलेशन प्रोसेस. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट न्यूमेरिकल मेथड्स. वी नीड टू चूज एल्गोरिथम्स फॉर दैट. फॉर सिमुलेटिंग फ्लूइड फ्लो अराउंड द एयरक्राफ्ट विंग, फाइनाइट वॉल्यूम मेथड कैन बी एम्प्लॉयड टू सॉल्व द डिस्क्रिटाइज्ड नेवियर स्टोक्स इक्वेशंस. इट डिवाइड्स द कॉम्प्यूटेशनल डोमेन इंटू कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम्स, कैलकुलेट्स फ्लक्सेस अक्रॉस फेसेस ऑफ दीज वॉल्यूम्स एंड अपडेट्स द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द फ्लूइड विद इन ईच वॉल्यूम ओवर ईच टाइम स्टेप. दिस मेथड इज सुटेबल फॉर हैंडलिंग द कंजर्वेशन लॉस इनहेरेंट इन फ्लूइड डायनामिक्स. नेक्स्ट इज द सुपर कंप्यूटर आर्किटेक्चर. इट कैन इन्वॉल्व पैरेललाइजेशन, विच यूटिलाइजेज द पावर ऑफ ए सुपर कंप्यूटर, ब्रेकिंग डाउन द सिमुलेशन इंटू टास्क दैट कैन बी परफॉर्म्ड साइमल्टेनियसली. इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ आवर एयर फ्लो सिमुलेशन, द कॉम्प्यूटेशनल डोमेन इज डिवाइडेड इंटू स्मॉलर रीजन्स एंड ईच रीजन इज असाइंड टू ए डिफरेंट प्रोसेसर. दिस अलोस द सिमुलेशन टू रन कॉन्करेंटली ऑन मल्टीपल प्रोसेसर, सिग्निफिकेंटली स्पीडिंग अप द ओवरऑल कंप्यूटेशन. Efficient memory usage is also critical. In a distributed computing environment, data may be scattered across different nodes. Techniques like data caching and minimizing data transfer between nodes are employed to optimize memory usage. The high-speed memory on each processor is used judiciously to store and retrieve data efficiently. Next up is code implementation, which can involve programming languages. The simulation code is implemented using a high-performance computing language such as Fortran or C++. For example, Fortran's code is structured to take advantage of parallelism with specific sections designed for each processor to handle. To optimize the code for the supercomputer architecture, various techniques are applied, like loop unrolling, where iterations of loops are executed in parallel, can enhance performance. Additionally, the code is tuned to minimize data dependencies, ensuring that each processor can work independently on its assigned task without waiting for data from other processors. For example, a snippet of Fortran code might include a loop over the control volumes, updating the fluid properties based on the calculated fluxes. The code would also include parallelization directives, such as MPI, to distribute the workload among processors. Optimization might involve using compiler flags to enable specific optimizations and restructuring code to maximize cache efficiency. In essence, the numerical methods and code implementation are tailored to leverage the parallel processing capabilities of the supercomputer, ensuring efficient and scalable execution of the simulation. Next is inputting the data. In the case of simulating airflow around an aircraft wing, the initialization involves setting up the initial conditions. This includes specifying the initial velocity field, pressure distribution, and temperature around the wing. These conditions represent the starting point of the simulation and influence the subsequent evolution of the airflow. Defining the boundary conditions is crucial for an accurate simulation. For our example, this involves specifying how the air interacts with the wing's surface and the surrounding environment. This includes setting the airflow conditions at the wing's surface, defining inflow and outflow conditions at the simulation boundaries, and considering any external factors affecting the airflow. Next one is execution. Submitting the simulation as a job to the supercomputer involves providing detailed information to the scheduler. This includes specifying the required computational resources, such as number of nodes, cores per node, and expected runtime, and any dependencies on external libraries. Job scheduling ensures efficient resource utilization on the supercomputer. Now, during execution, the progress of the simulation is closely monitored. This involves tracking computational performance metrics, checking for errors, and ensuring that the simulation progresses as expected. Visualization tools may be employed to monitor the evolving airflow patterns in real time or through periodic checkpoints. Next is data output. As the simulation progresses, various data points are collected. This includes information about the airflow patterns, pressure distribution, and other relevant parameters. These data points are stored for further analysis and visualization. Once the simulation is complete, post-processing steps are performed to analyze and interpret the results. Visualization tools generate detailed images or animations of the simulated airflow, aiding in understanding complex phenomena. Quantitative analysis may involve extracting key performance metrics such as lift and drag forces on the wing. Imagine the initialization phase, which involves defining the initial velocity field based on the expected flight conditions. Boundary conditions are set to simulate the interaction between air and the wing's surface. Job scheduling specifies the required computational resources, and execution monitoring ensures that the simulation progresses smoothly. Result collection involves storing detailed information about the airflow state at each time step, while post-processing generates visualizations showing how the airflow changes over time. These steps ensure that the simulation is not only accurately initiated and executed, but also that results are comprehensively collected and analyzed for scientific insights. Next is supercomputer verification and validation. Validation is the process of comparing simulation results with experimental data or other reliable sources to ensure the model accurately represents the physical system. For our aircraft wing simulation, this involves comparing the simulated airflow patterns, pressure distributions, and other relevant parameters with wind tunnel experiments or real flight data. While verification assesses the correctness of the numerical methods and implementation. This can be done by comparing simulation results against analytical solutions for simplified cases or by conducting benchmark simulations with known outcomes. Verification ensures that the simulation code correctly solves the discretized mathematical equations. Next is iterative process. Based on validation and verification results, the model, numerical methods, or code may need refinement. This iterative process involves making adjustments to improve the accuracy and reliability of the simulation. Refinements could include modifying boundary conditions, fine-tuning numerical algorithms, or updating the model based on new scientific insights. For example, if the simulated airflow patterns differ significantly from experimental data during validation, researchers might refine the model by incorporating additional factors like turbulence effects or adjusting parameters to better match real-world conditions. Verification might involve running the simulation with a simplified geometry for which analytical solutions are known, ensuring that the code produces the expected results. Next is documentation. Detailed documentation is crucial for transparency and reproducibility. This involves documenting the assumptions made in the model, the parameters chosen and any modifications to the code. It also includes keeping track of the simulation setup, such as initialization conditions and boundary conditions. For example, documentation might include a comprehensive report outlining the specifics of the aircraft wing simulation, including the governing equations, mesh details, validation and verification procedures, and a record of any refinements made. This documentation serves as a reference for researchers, enabling them to understand, reproduce, and build upon the simulation. Next up is communication. Sharing results with the scientific community is a vital step. This involves preparing research papers, presentations, or reports summarizing the simulation, its findings, and the implications for the broader field of study. Communication facilitates knowledge exchange and contributes to the collective understanding of the simulated phenomena. For example, researchers could present their findings at conferences, publish papers in scientific journals, or create visualizations to communicate complex airflow patterns around the aircraft wing. So, verification and validation processes ensure the accuracy of the simulation, iterative refinement improves its reliability, detailed documentation captures the intricacies of the simulation, and effective communication shares the knowledge with the wider scientific community. Now, there are many things that can be simulated using a supercomputer. Let us briefly talk about them. First is climate modeling. It involves simulating global climate patterns to understand and predict weather phenomena. Aerodynamic simulation, which is analyzing airflow around aircraft or vehicles for optimal design. Structural mechanics, which involves studying the behavior of materials and structures under various conditions. Quantum chemistry, which is simulating molecular interactions and reactions for drug discovery. Astrophysical simulations, which is modeling celestial phenomena like galaxy formation and black hole dynamics. Nuclear reactor simulations, which is evaluating the behavior of nuclear reactors for safety and efficiency. Fluid dynamics, which is investigating fluid behavior in applications from pipelines to ocean currents. Financial modeling, which is simulating the market behaviors and assessing risk in financial systems. Biomechanics simulations, which is analyzing the movement and stresses on biological structures. Particle physics, which involves simulating particle collisions to understand fundamental physics. Earthquake simulation, which involves predicting seismic activity and its impact on structures. Epidemiological modeling, which involves studying the spread of diseases within populations. Plasma physics, investigating high temperature and high density plasma behavior. Material science simulations, which involves understanding material properties for designing new materials. Urban planning, which involves simulating city growth, traffic patterns, and infrastructure development. Power grid simulations, analyzing the stability and efficiency of electrical grids. Human brain simulations, which is modeling neural networks for neuroscience research. Space weather modeling, which involves studying solar flares and their impact on Earth's environment. Fire spread simulations, which involves predicting the behavior of wildfires in different conditions. Ocean circulation models, which involves understanding the dynamics of ocean currents and climates. Supply chain optimization, which involves simulating logistics for efficient resource distribution. Virtual wind tunnels, which involves testing aerodynamics of cars, planes, and buildings. Social network dynamics, which involves modeling information flow and trends in online communities. Molecular dynamics, which involves simulating the movement of atoms and molecules in biological systems. Disaster response planning, which involves simulating emergency scenarios for effective response strategies. Virtual drug trials, which involves simulating drug interactions and efficacy before clinical trials. Renewable energy simulations, which involve optimizing the efficiency of solar and wind power systems. Traffic flow modeling, which involves analyzing congestion patterns and optimizing traffic management. Cosmic microwave background simulations, which involves modeling the early universe's radiation. Cybersecurity simulations, which involves assessing vulnerabilities and testing security measures in networks. So today we have delved briefly into how simulations are done. We can peer into the inner workings of a molecule, understand the flow of air around an aircraft wing, or even contemplate the dynamics of an entire universe, all made possible through the remarkable synergy of mathematics, computer science, and cutting-edge technology. The parallelization of algorithms, efficient memory management, and optimization techniques harness the full potential of these computational giants. We have talked about initiation of simulations, defining problems, discretizing time and space, choosing algorithms, and implementing them on the intricate architecture of supercomputers. Validation and verification ensure the reliability of our digital experiments, and the iterative nature of refinement molds simulations into increasingly accurate representations of reality.
Thank you very much for watching, and may we one day create millions of universe simulations indistinguishable from reality with customizable parameters and experience millions of different worlds.